Welcome. Thanks for stopping by. You need to get some sizing done for your jewelry. Of course, I'm more than happy to assist you today and help you find the sizes. Would we like to start off with the ring sizes? Okay. Yes, I have a few tools we can use, and then I'll bring a couple examples of some ring options we have. And the great thing about getting your sizes is that now you can order any jewelry you need, knowing the sizes you are. Here. The tools I'll be using. First off, we have a tool that will be able to size actual rings. See if we need to adjust them at all. Okay. Okay. So this is what the tool looks like. Okay. Then we have a couple more items. So we have an actual ring sizer to measure your finger. Another couple options are these almost zip tie looking contraptions. They have numbers on them. Okay. And for example, you can slip it through one side, like so, and adjust it the size of your finger, like so, and you just pull on the other tab here. Okay, and I can leave this with you today if you wish. Okay, now as we take your measurements, I'll be writing them in my little notebook, okay, and you'll be able to take them with you. Measure each finger. That way you know sizes for each one. Why, you ask? Oh, well, let me show. Our fingers each vary in different sizes. Some fingers are larger than others. For example, my ring finger here is very small compared to the middle finger. And of course, the pinky is much smaller, while the thumb is much thicker. It's good to measure all the fingers on both hands and mark which is left and right. So if you ever want to have a lot of rings, you can find the piece that fits the right finger. Does that make sense? Okay, great. So, shall we start off with your left hand? Okay, let me go ahead and mark my notebook. Okay, I'll mark the pinky first. That's usually a lot smaller. This next one. Get this one. Is that fit alright? You like that one? Okay. Let's see. Okay, that's okay. Okay, next we'll do the you like that one. Okay. All right. So that is okay. Then we'll do the next one. Okay, that one's probably going to be slightly bigger. Was that the perfect one? Wonderful. Look at that. It's like I know this stuff. Okay. Alright, and then we have the next one. This one might be around the same. You like that one? Okay. Good to go. And then last, your thumb. That might be a little bigger. Let's try this one. Okay. Let's try next one up here. That one works. Okay. And okay. All right, we got the left hand. Now, let's go ahead and do the right hand, if you would. Okay, yes, starting off. The small ones. We can try with the one that we selected earlier. You need slightly smaller. Okay. Let's try the next one. Yeah, sometimes it can be off by like a half or a quarter size. That one works, okay. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and put this one down. Alright. Let's go ahead and do the next one. No, you're doing great. This is going to be really great for you to find the jewelry you need. Okay, so let's move on to the next one. Last but not least is the thumb. How do you feel knowing all your ring sizes now? It's a really great item. We do sell these if you're interested in purchasing today, but of course now knowing your size, you probably don't need it as much. I will say though that our ring sizes can fluctuate throughout our life, so it's good to check every now and then, say a couple times a year. Especially if you're going through any bodily changes, which is completely normal as we get older. And of course, it's good to just check, and also you can get your jewelry sized correctly. So that leads us into our next tool that we'll walk through. Okay. So, Here we have our ring sizing tool. And I see you brought in some jewelry you want to size. Okay. So, looks like you brought in some jewelry items for us to size today. Alright, I can take down their measurements. And then you can decide if you need to resize anything accordingly. And some of these are for other people, okay? Then they can also decide. Yes, I'll be using this tool to mark down the sizes. Next ring, that one's very nice. It's about okay. Ooh, this one's like a snake. That one's very cool. Okay, that's this is a smaller one, I see. Yeah. That one is about 7.5. Okay. Next, we'll move on to the gold jewelry. So that's all the silver. One is very beautiful. And that one is about... Yes, now knowing all the sizes of these rings, you'll be able to decide which ring, which finger they would be most suitable. Signets can be a little bit tighter on the finger because they're a lot thicker. So you just have to be aware of that. They might look big, but they're actually a little bit tighter than you would expect. Exactly. Just keep that in mind. This ring. This one's about 8. this one looks unique. Okay. So that's roughly. So this one actually is an adjustable ring. So there's an opening in the back and you can widen the ring. So what you could do is use something like this to widen the ring a little bit more, but I caution you to be careful because depending on the material here, which I'm not positive of, you could end up breaking it. So just remember that when using an adjustable ring, that you're very careful widening the opening here because it is just two, you know, pieces of material that you're pulling apart. So just be careful. If you pull too hard, it could end up damaging the ring. Okay. But that's a very unique piece and a great example of finding things that can be adjustable. Sizes you prefer, and then also your wrist for watches and bracelets, and then arm cuffs, so up here or here. So the sizes for those you can find jewelry for. Okay. Yes, and I'll go ahead and write down all the sizes. I'm going to start with your wrist. Okay. Okay, so if you can hold your wrist out for me. Okay, let's see. And that was your left one, right? Okay. And let's do the other one, the right one. It's just about. Consistent. It's about okay. Perfect. And then do we want to do the arm? Just on each side, okay. So let's do the left upper arm. Yeah. Arm cuffs are very in. Or, you know, if you want to be a Greek goddess or god. Are very much part of the aesthetic. Okay. Okay, that's about that much. And let's do the right one now. Measurement and then also just lengthen depending on the length you prefer for necklaces. Okay. the exact size. Okay, thank you. So, let's see. That is that. And then the other way. Yeah. So, do you like that length or do you want it longer? Okay, a little longer. Okay. And you want to do one more option. Okay. Okay. A little longer. Okay. Okay. Alright, so it's about there. Alright. Alright, then I think that's pretty much all the measurements we need then, right? Anything else you might need today? No, okay. Then what I'll go ahead and do is make sure you have this piece of paper. And I will also give you a home measurement ruler. One of those zip tie ones I showed. Okay, and you can go home with those and then come back whenever you're ready to either size any jewelry or purchase anything that you'd like custom made. Okay. Can I get your name again? Okay. Okay. Just put that right there. Would you like to have a black measure or a white one? Up to you. You want the black one. Okay. Here you go. Put that in you there. Okay. Alright. Well, that completes our session today. If you have any other questions, feel free to call us or come by anytime, and we're happy to help you. Okay. Well, thank you again, and I hope to see you soon.